Hello everybody, welcome to another update on the Stock Screener. Today I wanted to talk about Argonaut Gold. As you can see on the screen, it has dropped 30% today. So something really bad happened. And I just want to tell everyone there is a risk in investing in gold mines, especially when they are in construction. So they have updated us on the construction capital, and it was not good. So let's take a look at the PEA, the PFS. So this is from 2016. So here you can see that they had an initial capital cost of 539. That's very high, 539 in 2016. Then the capex dropped to 320. So something really weird is happening. So apparently, they estimated first at very high cost in 2016, and then it went to 320. So that's already a red flag. Then they updated again in 2020 to 400 million. Okay? So you can see the inflation coming in here. And today, in 2021, you can see that the costs have gone from, this is in Canadian dollars, so from around 400 million US dollars to about 660 million US dollars. So from here to here is about a 60% increase. That's a lot. This is not normal. How can you have 60% increase in capital costs in just 1 year? So this is total incompetence from management. This is not inflation, okay? This is something else. So let's see what the changes are. So here we have 10% increase, that's normal, this is a lot. So this is already a 70% increase from here. So the tailings management facility was not calculated correctly. Here we have a doubling of the costs on site development. So something is wrong here as well. It's not calculated correctly. You cannot have a 100% increase. So this is a very poor estimate. Okay, so this has gone down. This as well, power, not calculated correctly, because this has gone up by double, more than double. This is not just inflation, this is just poor management. Then this again, that's also more than a double in capex on G&A. So I can't believe that we see more than 10 to 20% inflation here. This is just a double in costs. Here as well, very high adjustments on the capex. And that results in 60% increase in costs. So that's why investors are not happy to see this. And we can also calculate what the upside is now. So here, you can see it went up, the share price went up, and it seems like a good valuation here. I actually even owned the stock, but I sold it when it went up, so I'm pretty lucky here. But you can see that there is upside. When they have done the construction, then you can see that it has a double potential. I bought it here. So double potential, it went up and I sold. And now it crashed down again to below this price level. But there's a reason for this, of course. And that's the following. So the CapEx went from 370, 320, then going to, well, this is actually 500. And then, so they estimated it pretty good in 2016. But then they went down and then they went up and now it's back to 600. So this is something to consider. Why that these numbers fluctuate like this. But now we are back to $622. And they already used 300 of that. So we still have 350 million cash that needs to come from somewhere. And it will not be coming from their balance sheet because they have no cash left. Probably around 100 million cash left. So they will need to do a raise of, let's say, 300 million. So there will be dilution, 300 million dilution on 500 million market cap. So this is going to be a more than 50% dilution, okay? And then you can see this market cap will probably become 800 or 900 million. So instead of being here, due to the dilution, we will be back here. So the upside is limited now. The upside, I think upside is around 30% by next year if they achieve production, of course. Maybe the cost will go up even more by then, I don't know. But then we have a 20 to 30% upside. And it already crashed 30%, so you need to win more than 30% to get back to here. So, yeah, people who have invested in this company, they are not happy because they will never recover their losses now. Just wanted to share the risks when you invest in mining companies. And I'll see you in the next video.